You know who this guy is? Joe Hayden, the one with all the shoes.
Exactly.
Amanda had such a good time doing that piece on you. How many shoes you got?
Probably around like a thousand.
A pair for every occasion.
A pair for everything. I got a pair for golf, too.
I was just going to say, they're pretty snazzy. Get a shot of his shoes there, Brian.
Went and picked these up yesterday, man.
Oh, you're adding to your collection.
Yeah, for sure. I think I got 1,001 now.
Having a good time out there today?
Oh, man, of course. Of course. My team is holding me down. I think I just drove it 10 yards again. But they definitely, my man just knocked it all the way down, so we're good.
Yeah. In a way, I thought he was derogatory toward you guys. He said you're holding him down.
No, good holding me down. Like, I'm doing bad. They're picking me up.
Listen, mini camp won't be that long.
I know. When the camp's done, we got OTAs next week, and then we get a little bit of time off, and then come back in and the real deal starts. So I think everybody just coming here relaxing, all the coaches, players having a good time. But we know in a month it's going to get real.
Exciting about all the new draft picks adding to the roster.
Oh, definitely. I mean, Whedon, Trent. Of course, you can't be but excited about those two dudes.
Excited about you too. What a couple of years you've had, Joe.
Oh man, I'm ready for this year, man. This is going to be my coming out year for sure.
Go get him, partner.
Thank you.
All right. Andre. Thanks, Andre. Trent Richardson's with us here. Having a good time today?
Yes, sir. A very relaxing, good time today.
How'd the mini camp go?
It went real good. I enjoyed it and being around all the players and getting to learn, you know, all the, you know, the different plays and stuff that I, you know, got to come before me for this season. It was real good.
Nice facility in Berea, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, most definitely. Nice facility. It's almost, you know, I had to say them in Alabama and Cleveland is the best facilities I'd have been around.
Speaking of Alabama, you know, in the Cleveland Browns storied history, we had a Crimson Tide here who made quite a name for himself before you. Guy by the name of Ozzie Newsome.
Oh, yes, sir. He's an idol and an icon. And so you got a feeling in shoes like that, you can't do nothing but greatness.
You're coming to a division known for hardcore blue-collar football. Running back like you in store for a good time.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. Yeah. Smash my football all the time. That's what we're doing in Cleveland. That's what, you know, that's what we're all about.
Also, with you in the draft, we shored up that offensive line. They're excited about blocking for you.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. I'm excited about running behind them. But them guys that's in front of me, they're tremendous. Them guys, they're huge, and they very athletic and they ready to move the pile.
What makes you so attractive too is not only are you a great runner, but you got a good pair of hands. You like to catch the football coming out of the backfield.
Oh yes, sir. I try to be every down back, and so when it comes down to it, I work on my hands all the time.
Trent, love you. Have a good time today.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Well, coach, you hit a nice ball there.
It was a full swing. You know, I think we most of us ended up on the right. We kind of got the rights today, so we'll get that straight now and try to get some low scores here.
Where do you guys stand as a team? You got to be under.
I don't know. Let's not let it out yet.
Oh, no. It
might work the pencil, you know?
Reggie Rucker's not here.
No, no.
Oh, I didn't say. I love you, Reggie. Mini camp, everything went well?
It's been a great spring. We've got 4 OTAs left, you know, and I really feel good about the work we've gotten done. Players have gotten a lot better. The new guys are getting up to speed, and so it'll be exciting once we start training camp. It's right around the corner. Before you know it, we'll be playing games.
We already interviewed Whedon, and he's so polished.
Well, I think he's older than me, you know. But no, he's very mature. He's been through this before. He understands what it is to be a professional athlete, and he's done an outstanding job this spring, learning what we do and then showing us what he did in college. Very accurate, very strong arm. And a terrific leader.
And Richardson's a nice kid, too. Younger than Whedon, but he's also very mature for his age.
These guys played at big-time places, yeah. So they're not going to be intimidated by pro football, and I think that's part of what makes them terrific players. And he's a great competitor himself. Trent's done a nice job in the spring here, and I'm looking forward to seeing him with pads on.
You know, we talked about Whedon, we talked about Richardson, but you bolstered that offensive line, too, and for rush blocking and for pass protection, those guys both are going to need it.
Yeah, we like the guys we picked. Of course, Mitchell Schwartz, he's playing the right tackle spot, and you know, all things being considered, he'll probably be our guy there, based on what we've seen. But no, it's going well from that standpoint.
And you know, you made a great hire in Brad Childress too. Yeah. He's going to be a great aid for you. You're on the same page and all. What a background! Head coach as an offensive coordinator, head coach as a defensive coordinator, and you leading the group.
Well, Brad and I kind of learned this profession together in Philadelphia, and we had great success there under Andy Reid, and they do things the right way. And so that's where we learned it. That's where we visualized how to build it and how to coach offense within that system. And so Brad and I were immediately on the same page when I hired him, and to this point, he's done a great job.
Have a good time today, guys. Thanks, Coach.
All right, Andre, our left tackle, Joe Thomas, says, I thought you only fished and hunt.
You know, I like to get out on the golf course a little bit, so it's a fun day.
I should ask your partners here how long you hit the ball.
Pretty long, but not very straight.
You don't know where it's going?
Hopefully they don't tell you that one.
Hey, listen, I got to be excited with what we've added, Schwartz and everything, the offensive line. All of a sudden, you're the old-timer on that line.
Yeah, it's definitely a lot different than a couple years ago when I was one of the younger guys. But it's exciting having Schwartz out there and Ryan Miller and a couple new guys. I think we're going to be a much better line this year.
And Mac, of course, and a year more of experience for Pinkston and Laval.
Exactly. I think it's going to be a really good offensive line for years to come.
Also, Trent Richardson blocking for him. That's going to be fun.
Yeah, I can't wait to see him out there in the pads in the fall because he looks so good and so strong and so powerful right now. It's going to be fun watching him run people over in the fall.
You know, Joe, it's amazing. A couple of drafts and all of a sudden there's a totally new outlook for the team.
It's great. I mean, the things that Tom Heckert has done in only a couple seasons with the draft has been phenomenal. I mean, we're loaded with talent and we're all really young.
How's your family? All right?
Doing good. Real good.
Have a good time out here.
All right. Thank you very much.
All right. Carry this guy, will you, fellas?
I'm going to need the help. That's for sure.
Thanks, Tom Heckert, our GM, is joining us here at the Browns Foundation charity golf outing. All I know is if he didn't get called upon for business last year, where it is he would have won the par 3 shootout on STO?
That's right. No. Well, I mean, I made it to the finals, and unfortunately, I had to go away, so I couldn't do the finals. But no, it was a fun event.
We'll never know.
That's right. That's right.
Sort of like those draft choices, huh?
Exactly. You know, we've got our first little view of them these last couple weeks. So we have one more week this week. But so far, so good. We're really excited about the season.
You know, in a couple of years, all of a sudden, this offensive line not only looks solid, but it's young. Thomas is the oldest guy.
I know. Well, you know, and that's kind of the goal we had. You know, we wanted to get younger, but now this is our first year where we think we have enough depth in it. So if we get an injury, even like to Phil Taylor, we got an injury to him, but we think we have the depth to overcome some of those things. So, you know, I think we're on the right track.
You know, that's an omen now that you mention it, Tom. You draft these defensive linemen, and then it was after that the poor guy got hurt.
That's right. Well, you know, you can never have enough offensive defensive linemen. So, you know, I'm glad that it happened that way, but Phil's going to be back eventually, and we'll be okay.
And also, you know, Hardesty seems to be like, you know, the forgotten guy, but I know he's not in your eyes, even though we drafted Trent.
Oh, not at all. You know, he's had a great offseason. Him and Brandon Jacobs both are, Brandon Jackson have had great offseasons. So, you know, right now we think we have three legitimate running backs, and if they stay healthy, we're going to be tough to handle running the ball.
You know, Whedon's right behind you.
Yep.
And he told me he only took up the game of golf. You know, he played baseball, and then he decided, come, thank goodness, he's back in the NFLs with our team now, hopefully the quarterback of the future. But he said he only took up golf 4 years ago. He hit a drive. It must have been 325 yards behind you.
I know. Well, he's pretty good. Well, I was kidding. He played out at my club at Liquid on Saturday. 37 on the back nine. I say, well, he's playing too much golf, so he needs to get back to working on football and forget about the golf game.
Makes me want to vomit like Chris Perez.
That's right.
Tom, great to see you, pal.
All right, thanks.
Have a good day.
Thanks. Brandon.
Good to see you, big guy.
You too. How's everything going?
You know, you make me sick. 4 years is all he's been. He played baseball in the Yankee system, as we all know. 4 years is all he's been playing golf. First time he ever played, he shot 89. Now he's like a 2 handicap. You're going to be a pro bowler to send us right to that Super Bowl, man. You got to be.
I hope my football game is a lot better than my golf game is today. You know, I'm not hitting very good so far, but you know, I'm looking forward to the season. It's going to be a fun year.
OTAs, minicamp went well?
Going well. You know, we got 4 left, but yeah, they've gone real well. You know, obviously still learning, still making mistakes, but trying to, you know, learn from them. Don't make them twice. And I think at that position, our position, if you can do that, you get, you know, kind of a recipe for success.
Getting familiar with those receivers?
Yeah. Yeah. We got some guys that can really go get it. You know, a lot of young guys that, you know, really stepping up and got a lot of guys that can go get the football.
Nice compliment having a back like Trent Richardson, too.
He's not bad. He's not bad. He's a little bowling ball back there, man. He's a freak. First time I handed it off to him, he yanked it out of my hand. So I knew he meant business when he's run between tackles.
Family getting settled in. Know you're looking for a home?
Yeah, we're looking a little bit. You know, me and my wife went out this past weekend, looked at a few places. Haven't decided on one yet, but we're making steps in the right direction.
Welcome to Cleveland, big guy.
Appreciate it. Thanks for having me.
keep hitting him 325 right down the middle. I'm telling you, he makes me sick, absolutely sick. Have a good day, guys. Thanks, all right, Andre, back to you.